Shalom everyone, this is Simone with Trinity of Love Ministries. So I just have a quick word the Lord wanted to share. This is a very, very specific word for some of you that obviously this word is for and that the Lord's already been speaking to you. So just a word of encouragement, confirmation, and a bit of wisdom perhaps, because some of you have maybe been battling or trying to understand what the Lord wants you to know. So as you can see, the prophetic word is a timeless, matchless love. A timeless, matchless love, right? A love that fills to overflow is here, right? This is a timeless and a matchless love. And yes, this word is for kingdom marriages that the Lord's talking about, and that they're here for a lot of you, and you know it. Like, this is not, you're not confused, but this is just the Lord wanting you to understand and be reminded of what he's doing. So I'm gonna just pray and then I'll jump into the word. Father, we thank you for your love. We thank you for your Holy Spirit that covers your people, and your blood that covers everything, that you've done all things on the cross. Everything is finalized and complete, and that we are covered in your protection and what you did at the cross. And we thank you for your protection according to Psalm 91. The angels that are loosed on guard, that are protecting your sons and daughters, protecting the kingdom marriages, protecting their children, their household, their finances, anything that they need in this hour, or the things that they're about to step into, Father, that they're covered by your blood, and it's already done and ordained at the cross. And we thank you for the manifestation of it now, the fullness of it now. We thank you for the new life in you, Lord, first and foremost, and in the new life with the partners that you've ordained for their lives, Father. We just thank you for your mighty hand upon their lives, for your protection, for your love, your grace, and your mercy, Father. We love you dearly. We honor you, we glorify you, and may these marriages just continue to honor and glorify who you are, which is true love, pure love, royalty at its best and finest. And we just thank you, we love you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray, amen. Hallelujah. And again, so the Lord is saying that this is a timeless and a matchless love, right? And that it is here and it will fill you to overflow, this type of love, because it comes directly from him, right? I've given a word on kingdom marriages before in last year, but the Lord is, this is like, he's like, it's here, this is it. And for some of you, you might have just met this person, or you will soon, or you, you know, again, you obviously take this word to the Lord. It's not for everybody. Again, these are for people who prepared, ready, the Lord's pruned you, and that you were waiting for this, right? But the Lord is saying that when this love comes, or if it's here, right? So we know the enemy will do whatever, but the he has no hold, right? Love always wins. God always wins. God is love. And so he has no hold on your mind, on your body, on your spirit. He has no hold on your partner as well. And so what God puts together, no man can tear apart, right? We know that. And that whatever little attacks or even like mental distractions, that we bind that up in the name of Jesus, that you have full clarity on who this person is in your life. Or, and again, they're going to flow by the Spirit of the living God. So there's not going to be any confusion, because the Lord's saying, I've confirmed it to you over and over and over and over again. So when will you trust me? When you will begin to trust me? And the Lord's saying he knows that some of the doubt has come from past relationships, even though this person is not giving you any doubt, anything to fear, but it's just your own. In a way, you're still in your flesh a little bit. So the Lord's saying to continue to come up higher in praise, in worship, you know, if you need to do a fast or whatever, but you're not fasting to get anything. You're just fasting so your spirit man remains in the Lord, right? Your mental state, your physical, your emotional. But the Lord is saying, like, yes, just like he I prophesy to other people, and he said to you in your secret place that this love is so beautiful, this love, because it comes from him, right? It's the Holy Spirit in between the two of you, right? The couple, the man, the woman, the divine couple. And he was referring me again to the word I did 2 years ago about Song of Solomon, right? 555, Grace for Marriages. So definitely go back and listen to that if you need and want encouragement. And that's definitely an in-depth teaching. This is just like a quick word he wanted me to release. as a confirmation that your love is here, right? And it's, or but for some of you, it's coming soon. And that, again, you're not going to be confused when it comes. It's going to take you suddenly and by surprise, but when it comes, you're going to know, right? And but that the enemy will try to use little things in maybe your spouse's past or your past, that it won't hurt or hinder anything, but it's just a moment of like trying to plant seeds of mistrust or doubt, not even mistrust, just doubt on really on what God is saying, not the person per se. And so the Lord is like saying to trust him, to trust his word, to trust what he's already spoken over you, trust what you know, what you've seen in the secret place, but also what you're seeing in this person, right? That there, this is just a pure love, a love that's respectful, right? A love that's joyful, a love that produces the fruit of the Spirit, right? Love, joy, peace, patience, understanding, right? And that whatever you're going through, right? Because some of you, he's going to allow you to build together, right? It's not that this person comes perfect or you're perfect, meaning like they have everything all together or whatever, but because, and some of you might, but not all, because a lot of these relationships also, the Lord wants you guys to build together. So therefore, you're not going to come, like, say, with, you know, the house, the car, the business, the ministry, everything all perfect and aligned, and you're bam, you know, because some, a lot of times, God wants you to build together, to grow, and that's part of your level of trusting each other, and to know without a shadow of a doubt, like, this person doesn't want you for this or that. They just purely love you for love's sake, right? That unconditional, that agape love. And that's the beauty of these kingdom marriages that God is bestowing upon his children. Like, for those who've been ready and prepared and purified, because you can easily destroy something like this if you go back into a negative mindset, or you speak words of doubt or negativity over it, right? But the Lord won't allow it, because again, he's putting these together, but you don't want to bring any delay or hindrance or anything like that. So the Lord is just saying, continue to speak life, remember your words, speak life, speak into, pray into your marriages, into your relationships that are, you're courting or whatever the case may be, or you're literally, you just entered or you are about to. And you know, again, just move in silence, like I've mentioned before. But he's saying that this, yes, this love is real. It is. And why he has me saying this, because it's gonna be so, it's like nothing you've ever seen. It's not exemplified in anything you've seen or known in your own personal life or family. Again, and that's why he's bringing this, to restore that covenant that he always created of a man and woman, and what pure love looks like, because it's God's love in between you two, right? That what it really looked like between Adam and Eve in the garden, what it really felt like, what it really meant to build together, right? To take dominion together, not just one over the other, right? One of you might be more proficient or well, you know, well-grounded in one area of knowledge or business or whatever expertise, where the other, again, it's the, when one is down, the other one can help, or where one lacks in something, the other one builds up, right? And so that you two complement each other, you paired well. But the Lord is saying, this love, it's so, right, it's about your assignment, right? Your kingdom assignment, to help deliver people, to help save, heal, to help bring them to the kingdom, the body of Christ. But it's also about just you two being an example of what walking love looks like on the earth, right? True, pure laughter, amazing joy, right? That restoration of that childlike faith, that childlike love, where you just love each other because you know you're sent from the Lord. And that is what this timeless, matchless love that the Lord is bringing and is here is about, right? He's saying, when I restore, meaning, and when I talk about restoration, I'm not talking about you going back to somebody in the past. I'm talking about, and I've said it in that word, the teaching on Song of Solomon, restoration of that promise of marriage over you, right? Or the promise of love, right? Because if, again, if it's, you have an abusive past, or, you know, a person that doesn't reciprocate, God's not going to bring that person. Like, yes, he can restore all things, but that's only if, again, that person was meant for you and the enemy came in between and it was like a separation or something. But a lot of these are brand new couples, brand new people you don't know, you haven't seen before, all these things, right? Even though in your spirit you might have felt like, I sense you, I felt you, I've seen you, because again, you're connected in the spirit. and the Lord is now bringing you two together, right? And so the Lord's saying, yes, this love is so mind-blowing because it comes from me. That's how good I am. That's how merciful. That's how loving, gracious, and it's a reciprocal love. So he wants, when you receive this, to open your heart, yes, but to also remember, because some of you might find this in a time where you need them or they need you, and to just remember to reciprocate that love, and it's gonna flow. But to just, again, the key is to have the Lord in the middle, your prayer time, worship, but then also your keep your own personal time with the Lord so that the Lord can speak to you specifically, right? That, say, if you're out of balance of something, and that your partner will understand, but that you want to make sure you're reciprocating that love back to that person, right? And so, again, the Lord is just saying that, believe it, to trust him, and obviously go to him with everything, but that this love is so pure, it's mind-blowing, it's so amazing, it brings out that childlike nature in you again that you thought you lost, right? That the enemy was trying to steal that light, that joy, that purity. And that's how much the Lord is restoring and healing on a deep, deep level. Every pain, every broken thing in your heart. Hallelujah. And he wanted me to read 1 Corinthians. He wanted me to read the scripture, the very famous scripture, 1 Corinthians, to remind you of what the fruit of love looks like and what real love looks like, right? Not the fake, worldly, fleshy love, right? Because say this person is going to fulfill things in you that you thought weren't there, or vice versa anymore, right? And they're going to produce things. It's going to be like, because he is, the Holy Spirit is right there with you both, right? So 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 4 to 8. 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verses 4 to 8. And it says, love is patient, right? That's the key. They're going to have patience. You're going to have patience. Or you're going to want to, or the Lord will work on you, and he's already worked on you before you.